life's riding on an autobahn on autopilot. Before I touch dirt, I'll kill y'all.
How you doing? I'm James from Directing Team Syndrome. We're here in Detroit filming the video for Bad Meets Evil.
The song's called Fastlane. I myself, Evil, am on it. My friend, Bad, my counterpart, and also Sly sings the hook.
It's the first single from the album. It's straight lyrical, you know what I'm saying? No conforming for radio or anything like that. It's just straight raw hip hop.
It's a moving track, you know what I mean? Up tempo. I was blessed to be a part of it. These guys have been in the lab just putting together, you know, for these last few months.
Even though, you know, it's Fastlane and it's Bad, Evil, it's M and Royce, it's all it's all in the family. So couldn't have this go down without being a part of it, without just supporting it and just whatever they need.
I just heard there was free catering. I'm with it.
Yeah, it's a good thing you got a shot at me getting these cookies, man, because that could be a gem one day.
Basically, we're here in Detroit. We're in this, like, decrepit warehouse that you don't really want to sit down on anything or whatever, but it sets for a nice canvas of what we're shooting. What can I say? It's amazing. I mean, this song is insanely infectious. You know, it's two amazing lyricists that are essentially continuing where they ended off, and they're continuing it now, and they're coming out hard as hell.
It's dazzling. That's the word that I'm using for the EP, dazzling. It's 11 songs. 9 songs, 2 bonus songs. Dazzling.
It's not an album, it's an EP, but it's actually a little longer than an EP, but a little bit shorter than an album. We weren't really sure what to call it, so we just call it an EP. Like EP, short for epic. Maybe you
should listen when What's really cool about working with Em and his team is they'll come at you with an idea. You know, we really want to do something where we see the lyrics, you know, like Em is within the lyrics.
There's a lot of words in this song. I thought maybe it would be a cool concept or a cool idea to play around with words, kind of like we're doing in the song, and take words and kind of throw them around, bounce them off walls, do all kinds of shit with the words, you know what I'm saying?
It started with a lot of ideas that Em had. He wants to do something where we're like playing with words because we're doing a lot of back and forth. And it's a lot of words flying everywhere. Like when you listen to it, it just sounds like pandemonium. He wants to do things with the words to where we're performing to the camera and kind of like smacking the words around.
Because there's so many metaphors and almost like hidden messages that if you just listen to it, you're gonna miss. So we're trying to put a visual to a lot of what they're saying so that it'll really translate across the board. So really there's 3 components to the shoot. We have what we're calling the alternate performance take, which is low angle, back lot of the warehouse. We want to shoot something that's essentially, you know, really raw, like straight up hip hop, like old school, and really frame Em in a way he hasn't been seen in a while. It's just letting them run loose. There's no technical aspect to it. They just do them, and it's really about capturing the camaraderie and the energy that's carried through the artist.
We kind of inspire one another. We kind of vibe off one another. I guess the good word is bounce. We bounce off each other.
Our next setup is what we're calling our master performance, but it's much more technical. It's where every line of the song is broken down into blocking and action. So we have the playback, the song, we have it broken up into a lot of different key points. Beyond that, we're just going around. I mean, this place has so much texture and like random imagery that like you can't make this stuff up. So we're going around with a second unit and just picking off textures, layers, things that we can cut through throughout the video and really kind of help paint the picture, you know, around just the performances. I'm living the life of the infinite enemy down. He's very particular about his shots, so it's really important with him to have like a script supervisor on set so that there's someone, after he does a take, he likes to watch that take to kind of see where he needs to go with the next thing. And at that point, he starts picking out moments that he likes from specific takes. Then our script supervisor documents everything, and then on the edit phase, we basically have all our selects. And then we move into the official post, and that's where we start compositing all of the lyrics and little icons that are gonna exist within space. And we're shooting it very handheld and organic, so when we put those graphics and typography into the frame, so they'll be tracked and they'll be in 3D space. So if the camera moves like this, that's the text will move with it.
There's absolutely no creativity in this video at all. There's a little bit of creativity. A little bit.
It's not like our workout. It happens naturally. I don't know what you do.
Don't really ham it up. Y'all stay tuned.
Oh, it went great, man.
Whew. It's a look that M's never done. Him doing it is really gonna make it special and take it to another level.
I think bar for bar is gonna be unmatched.
Tiff.
Yo, y'all going crazy.
No, you better fucking believe that one. That one, I wasn't even gonna say. That one you could bet on, though.